In that tutorial, you are going to discover how to implement the Countdown Mat Game on Android with Android Studio. The Countdown Mat Game, also known as Good Count Mat Game, is a game involving number puzzles in which you must make arithmetic operations to reach a random target number between 100 and 999 from six other numbers chosen randomly from 1 to 10, 25, 50, 75, and 100. The solution we are going to implement is based on a recursive algorithm. To modelize the operation in the Countdown Mat Game, we are going to create an operation interface exposing two methods. We create an operation interface with an eval method which takes in parameter x and y and makes the operation with them to return the result. And a symbol method returning a string representing the operation considered. Now we must create the implementation of each operation considered. Addition, subtraction, division, and multiplication. We create the add implementation. We implement the eval method by adding the two parameters. Now we create the subtract implementation. We implement the eval method and the symbol method. In the eval method, we return the result for the subtraction between x and y parameters. And in the symbol method, we return the minus symbol. Now we implement the divide operation, which implements the operation interface. We implement the eval method and the symbol method. In the eval method, we return the result of the division of x by y, or y by x, if x is lower than y. And we return the divide symbol in the symbol method. Finally, we implement the multiply operation. We implement the eval method and we return the result of the multiplication of x by y. And in the symbol method, we return the multiply symbol. Now we need to create the user interface of our countdown math game. Our interface will have a text view associated to an edit text to let the user entering the number to use, and another text view associated to an edit text to let the user entering the target to use. And finally, a button to start the resolution of our countdown math game. We can see the preview in the design view. We continue by adding a margin left on the text view of 10 dp and margin top of 10 dp. We click on the design view to preview the result. OK. We can make the same for the target to use, the target to reach. And finally, we add the button to start the resolution of our countdown math game. And we see the preview in the design view. We add more margin on the top with 40 dp. OK, it's great. Now it's time to write the Java code of our main activity. We declare a static array to store the operations to apply. We create implementation for the add, subtract, multiply, and divide operations. And then we are going to declare a solution field, which is an array list which will contain the solution to count to find. Now we create the find solution method. The find solution method is the heart of our algorithm to solve the countdown math game. In parameters, we take an array containing the number to use, the number of elements to consider, and the total to target. We iterate on the number to use. If the total to target is already in the number to use, we return true because the solution is already there. Then we continue by iterating on the number to use. And we apply each operation. So we iterate on the operation array. We apply the eval method and we get the result of the current operation. If result is different of 0, we put the result in the new list of numbers to use. And we call recursively the find solution method with new numbers to use, and we decrease number of elements to use by one. Finally, if solution is found, we add the current operation to the list of operations, letting us to find a solution. And don't forget to return true. Now we create a print solution method. The print solution method will be used to print the operation leading us to the solution found. We iterate in a reverse way in the solution array list, and we print solution in the builder. Object. Finally, we display all these results in an alert dialog to inform the user of the solution found. We declare the field for our user interface, both edit text and button. And in the onCreate method, we get the references and we instantiate the cooldown mat game object. We set an onClick listener on the solve button. In the onClick method, we get the numbers defined in the edit text and the target to reach. Convert the string object got from the text to numbers by using the integer dot parseInt method. We make the same operation for the target to reach. In a real application, you should check if the numbers entered in the edit text are really numbers by catching eventual exception. Then we start the resolution of the game by calling the findSolution method. If a solution is found, we call the printSolution method to display the result to the user. If there is no solution, we display a dialog to the user to alert him there is no solution for this count. Now it's time to try our countdown map game by clicking on the run button on Android Studio. We need to wait during the Gradle build. We forgot to get the references of the solve button, so we relaunch the application. Okay, we can enter the number separated by a space and then the target to reach. We enter 100, 2. 75, 3, 1, and 10. And the target to reach will be 848. We click on the solve button to launch the resolution of our countdown mat game. There is no solution. Maybe there is a bug, because there is a solution for this count. So we look to the code. We enter in debug mode. We check if the numbers are good. Okay, it looks great. For the numbers. So we need to check the findSolution method. just after the if final solution call, we forgot to set the new values for the number to use. We click on the run button to relaunch the application. Okay, so we can enter the numbers. One hundred, two, 75, 3, 1, and 10. And the target to reach will be 848. And we click on the solve button. Okay, the count is found with the operation displayed to the user. You can change the target to reach. You can enter 534, and the operations are displayed. But there is a problem. There is the previous operations which are displayed. So we need to clear the array list when we start a new resolution of count. We call the clear method of the solution array list. We enter the numbers and the target to reach before launching the resolution. Okay, it works. An improvement will be to make the resolution in another thread to avoid blocking the user interface thread. It will be a good exercise for you. That's all for the tutorial. To discover more tutorials on Android development, don't hesitate to subscribe to the SRL channel.